Welcome to Cute Widgets and More. In this episode, we'll talk about the difference between a city and a country. Well, QString city, QString country, how do the compiler tell the two apart? Well, we'll talk about a class or a template or whatever it is called strongTypeDef that will help us help the compiler tell these two apart. Let's jump right into the code to see what is really the problem. The problem is that I have this method here, print city. It takes a city and a country and it prints it out. When I write print city New York City, USA, wait, New York City, that's not a country. There's no help from the compiler because the compiler will just think of them as two QStrings, as they are given. Even worse, if I have a hash from QString to QString of capitals, I can't tell which of these, from just looking at these few lines of code, which of them is correct. Is it a map from the city to the capital, or from a city, a capital, to the country, so that I always can figure out which country a given city is capital of? Or is it from the country to the city, so I easily can look up which city is the capital of a given country? One of these two must be wrong. And of course, it's this one here, because everybody knows that Denmark is the capital of Sweden. Wait. So all the way back from the beginning of time, we had TypeDef, which in C++11 got modernized to be using. So basically the parameters was moved around so that they were more easy to read. And sometimes that does help. Let me show you how it helps in our situation here. What you see here is that I now have this using city equal to QString, using country equal to QString. And of course it doesn't help in the calling here, because I would have liked to have a kind of a tooltip when my mouse was hovering over USA telling me that this was the city. See, if I had done like this, well, had I done like this, there we are. Now it tells me, now you're ready to type in the city, and everybody knows that US is the capital of New York City. But it does help me with my using down here. Now I at least know that it's a hash from a country to a city, and that's already a good start. But there's more. The underlying problem to it all is that the compiler cannot tell the difference between a QString and a QString. Even though I wrote using country equal to QString, throughout all of the code, the compiler would just see QString because the using syntax is just purely syntactic sugar. There is a solution to this. I could write class country colon public QString, and then everywhere where I would take a QString previously, I would now take a country class. And that's exactly what we will be doing in the next step. We'll not write those class country whatever ourselves. We'll use a framework that is called strongTypeDef, and the strongTypeDef basically creates new classes for each of those. Here's the syntax. Using city equal to, and then this JSS colon strong type def, taking a struct city tag. I'm not entirely sure on what this is used for, but nevertheless, and then the underlying type. And if I just press F2 here, you can see that it will actually create a class, a templarized class, and lots of stuff here. And basically what I'll get is a new class for this stuff here. And I just call that new class city so that it's easier to maneuver around. I also have the same thing for my country. And there's a third parameter to this strong type def for the country, namely the strong type def properties. And there's a lot of these strong type def properties. I can most easily show you that by simply saying JSS colon colon strong type def properties colon colon. And here you can see a list of all of these different strong type properties. What they basically allows us is to say, I want this one to be comparable. And comparable means that it has a less than and a greater than and so on. I can also have it equality comparable, which means I will only have the equal to and not equal to, the equal to and not equal to operators. There are hashable, streamable, and so on, lots of different things. And based on those, my class will get the proper overloads. Now, with these two things, I have two very different classes given for the first parameter and second parameter here. So if I went down here, I have a country Brazil and the city is Brasilia. If I made the call to my print city, if I move the parameters around here, you would see that it would actually give me a compile error now, no matching function for call to print city. And if we just compile it, then you can see no matching for print city, candidate functions are, and then these tags, not necessarily in the most easily readable error message, but at least I get an error now saying, hey, you moved the country and the capital around. Also, my hash here now is on different classes. And for that, I of course need a qHash on the country. So that's what I do up here. qHash with this country here and the seat. And I basically just call qHash on the qString underneath. And how do I get to the qString underneath? Well, I do that using underlying value, which is a method that will return me the underlying value, actually return me a reference or const reference to that underlying value, namely the qString in both cases. The next part of my journey was to make it just slightly more bearable. Did I really need to have a qHash set up for each of my strong type def? And how about the dot underlying underscore value? Could that be done easier? Well, remember what we did with the enums, the strong enum, those enum class thing. We did this with the plus operator. Can we do the same thing? And here's the code. And here you can see there is no dot underlying value here. I simply have this operator plus in front of it. You can see no implementation of a qHash, despite that I use a qHash. And if we go look at this header up here, that is for you to just cut and paste out of qwidgets and more and put it into your own code base. You can see there is the operator plus, similar to what we had with the strong enums or the enum class stuff. And that actually coexists very well with that. And we also have a qHash here, and we even have a qdebug operator less than. So you can see up here, I actually print out two different ways that I took my plus country here to convert that into a qString, or I could just give it the country and it worked out of the box. You saw how I wrote JSS :: strong type def properties :: comparable to add the comparable operator to that strong type def. But for the qHash and the qdebug, I made them global. Shouldn't I have done the other way? And could I have done the other way? Yes, I could have done the other way. There are no reason for me to do that. I see no value in preventing you from actually running qdebug on your own type, but maybe you will find a way. And if you do so, you can create your own mixins that is similar to the comparable. You can write that and looks like this. What you need to do is to write code that looks more or less like this. So give it a namespace here. That's just so I can write q strong type def properties :. And then if I had a bunch of them streamable and whatnot. So this one is streamable. That is that you can stream it in and out using qDataStream. And for doing that, you need to overload this operator less than, operator greater than, taking a qDataStream and taking the underlying value that's derived. That's what it's called in here. And I simply create this mixin struct that is temporized on these two things. And by magic underneath, I will now, if I write qStrong typedef _properties :: streamable, I'll get these two methods so that I can create a country here. And this was my country. I can create a country. I can data stream my country into a buffer and I can stream it out of the buffer again. And that's pretty neat. Bonus points for whoever, without Googling, can tell me which country is Republica of Jara. Anyway, this was it for this episode here. I actually went ahead in my own code base to introduce strong type def in a number of places. I had, especially in the accounting module, OK Data Viewer, I had two different kind of accounts, namely the counting ID locally for each of the KDAP companies. And then we had a IFRS, go look it up if you have that kind of fetish, which was also an ID. And sometimes there was a risk of mixing those two. So I made them into strong type def. Was that easy? Was that just a matter of a few lines of adding? No, it wasn't. It was somewhat painful, but at least I sleep much better tonight knowing that I have nowhere mixed these two up, because now they are actual different types. I'm Jesper Petersen from KDAP. You've been watching Cute Widgets and More. Let me have your thoughts. Let me know if you tried adding strong type def to your code base, and especially let me know if you implemented a bunch of new mix-ins that could be useful to other viewers of Cute Widgets and More. Until next time, have a great time.
Wait, there's more. On June 13th to 15th, KDAP is gonna host a Qt developer conference in Berlin, in person. I'll be there, and I hope you'll be there too. Check out the program below. Trust me, there is gonna be something super interesting for widgets developers too.